Hey everybody, this is Brooke with Traveling Youth. This is a tutorial for Umbrella, the Rihanna song. This was by request, and it's a fun song to play anyway. So we're going to learn it in the original key, and then I'm also going to teach it half a step down. It'll make it a little bit easier if you're a beginner. So we're all going to learn this drum pattern together, and a little bit about the song structure, and then if you want to learn that beginner version, you can look in the comment box below, and then skip ahead to learning the beginner chords. So for the strum pattern, we're going to practice that strum pattern just on a C chord, so that's the bottom string of the third fret, and it's also one of the chords that's in the beginner version of it. So on C, we've got down, down, up, up, down, down. Up to speed, it's going to sound like this. Down, down, up, up, down, down. Down, down, up, up, down, down. You can even throw in, to make it a little more complicated, a little more rhythmic if you're more of an intermediate player. Down, down, up, up, down, down, up. A little bit slower, that's down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down. So that's it for the strum pattern. This song has a verse, a chorus, and a bridge. The verse and the chorus are almost the same. There's one little spot where there's kind of two options that you could have for chords. It's a little bit contested for all the resources I've found on the internet. So you can choose how you'd like it to sound, and I'll show you where that is. So as far as the original key, the chords that we're going to learn are F sharp, so the bottom three strings of the first fret, the third string of the second fret, and the top string of the third fret, so it's F sharp. C sharp, the bottom two strings of the fourth fret, the second string of the fifth fret, and the top string of the sixth fret. So when you're moving between F sharp and C sharp, if you want, you can use that pointer finger as an anchor. So you're just kind of moving up the frets, and then you move your finger up. That's one way that you can attack those chords. And then we've got F, the third string of the first fret, and the top string of the second fret, F. And then A sharp minor, the bottom three strings of the first fret, and the top string of the third fret. So this is a lot like G sharp, it's just missing that middle finger. Or sorry, F sharp. A lot like F sharp. And then, let's see, two more chords. One of them is G sharp, so you've got the same position as F sharp, but you're going to move it up two frets. So you've got the bottom three strings of the third fret, the third string of the fourth fret, and the top string of the fifth fret. This is G sharp. And then B, so the bottom two strings of the first fret, the second string of the third fret, and the top string of the fourth fret. This is B. So again, those chords are F sharp, C sharp, A sharp minor, F, G sharp, and B. So for the verse, we're going to play F sharp, C sharp, F, and then A sharp minor. F sharp, and we repeat that pattern. Sharp minor. So the sort of hotly contested chords that I found other people teaching this at different places on the internet and using my own ears. In the chorus, we've got F sharp, C sharp, just like the verse, but then G sharp. And in the verse, it's F sharp, C sharp, and then F. But actually, because the production of this like original single is pretty bare, you can actually just play, pick one of those, either the F or the G sharp, and play the whole thing with one or the other, and it actually will sound okay. So we've got F sharp, C sharp, and then you can pick either F or G sharp, kind of depending on how you want it to sound. So, yeah, that's going to be a little bit contested. I may get some thumbs down for it, but that's my personal opinion on the F and G sharp subject in this song. So, for the chorus, let's just go with the standard way though. F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, and then A sharp minor. So it sounds like this. F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, A sharp minor. Because when the sun shines, we shine together. So this is B, F sharp, and then C sharp. And you hang on that C sharp for a minute before going back to B. And then F sharp again. And then this time we go to F. And then back into the chorus with F sharp. So that bridge with the lyrics sounds something like this. What are those lyrics? Pull them up here. Oh, yeah.
You can run into my arms. It's okay, don't be alarmed. Run into me. Some gonna let the rain pour on me. I need it more. Because when the sun shines, we'll shine together.
And then you go back into the chorus. So that's it for Umbrella in the original key. Now I'm going to show you beginner chords. They're half a step down really quick. So for the beginner version, for the verse, we've got F, C. So F is the third string of the first fret and the top string of the second fret. C, the bottom string of the third fret. E, the bottom string of the second fret and the top three strings of the fourth fret. E. I like to play E like this. And A minor, the top string of the second fret. So this is for the verse, F, C, E, A minor. You just repeat that for the verse, that pattern. F, C, E, A minor. As the verse, we have F, just like the verse, and C, just like the verse, and then we're going to play G instead of E. So G is the second and bottom string of the second fret, and the third string of the third fret, G. And then A minor again. So F, C, G, A minor. So there's one little bridge part of this song. It's the "you can run into my arms" part. So that is B flat, the bottom two strings of the first fret, the second string of the second fret, and the top string of the third fret. B flat, F, like we played before, and C, like we played before. So that bridge sounds like this. B flat, F, C. You hang on that C before you go back to the B flat. And then F, and then this time instead of C, we're going to go to E. And then that E, and they're going back to F for the beginning of the chorus. So that bridge, B flat, F, C, B flat, F, E, sounds like this with the lyrics.
You can run into my arms, it's okay, don't be alarmed, run into me.
So I hope that's clear enough. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. And subscribe, make some suggestions, and I'll see you soon with another tutorial. Bye!